Hey, it's Noctis. Subscribe to Vincent Valentine EX Turk channel.
What's going on? This is your King Knight Vincent Valentine EX Turk with another Gladiator Battle of the Century of the... Or should I say Gladiator Battles of Final Fantasy characters from two different universes. And who will go at this time? So we'll put two warriors with a similar type of fighting style and type of background story type in order to face it off in the Death Battle Coliseum of the Final Fantasy Death Battle. This is All Too Bossy by Mountain Dew Spike Raspberry Lemonade. That is the good stuff. So, let's get to it. Our first contendant would be the Imperial Army, the Galbadia Army's top soldier, Laguna Lawyer. Now, if you don't know who haven't played Final Fantasy VIII, Laguna Lawyer is actually Squall's father. Shocking. So he kind of has some of the same fight style as Squall. That's how come when you play Squall and in the dream sessions you play as Laguna, because Laguna is Squall's father. President of Galbadia later on, you know, who ends up, you know. Now, let's talk about his powers and stuff like that. We know from what we played in Dissidia in Final Fantasy VIII, he can use any gun tactics, throw grenades. He's just pretty much a military man who knows his stuff. He knows his enemies, his weaknesses. And, you know, besides his charismatic personality, that's like Zack Fair's personality, Laguna Lore pretty much could get any job done, no matter how dangerous it is. In fact, Laguna Lore was the man who... Laguna Lore was the man who set Sorceress Adele onto the moon and sealed her up on the moon. So he would be the first man to actually successfully defeat Sorceress Adele, one of the strongest sorceresses in Final Fantasy VIII's lore, next to Ultimicia. And Sorceress Adele with some of the monsters onto the moon, thus saving the world and him becoming president. Now, his tactics are mostly just gun tactics. Now, one of his ultimate limit break attacks is the satellite beam. And the satellite beam pretty much has a giant satellite beam that's kind of like, compare it, it'd be like Superman's laser vision, pretty much. It will wipe out everything in the map. Which Laguna wouldn't do that right away. He'd use his machine guns, his handguns, grenades, and all that stuff. As well as his martial arts skill. And his high skill in magic as well. Because Laguna knows how to do the draw system and draw powerful magic like Squall does. Well, he's Squall's father, so what can you do? Now, the other combatant is one of the Niflheim's best experiments, second to Ravis, and son of Versteel, the scientist of Niflheim, Prompto Argentum, one of the bros. So, let's just see how this gets started. Okay, Prompto pretty much can do gun stuff, pretty much. Pretty much magic, though he's actually the weakest of the brothers. Though he is good, he's a good tactician, and he's good with all sorts of handguns, arm guns, you know, a whole arsenal. Pretty much, Prompto is a master at arsenal tactician type, you know, combat. And pretty much with all of that, he could do even more than you think he can, pretty much. So, with that, Prompto pretty much is a master. You're pretty much a master arms wielder. As well, he can use some magic as well. Prompto Argentum also has a gun that, a gun attack that pretty much fries demons known as the Bright, where he could shoot a fake sun in the air, thus weakening demons, which is very good on your own. He's also part Magitek, so pretty much he's an non-perfected version of Ravis, because Ravis was a perfected MT. In fact, Idolus trained Ravis himself. So pretty much, Prompto is pretty much a failed version of what Ravis became. But remember, with Cloud and Sephiroth, the failure known as Cloud became successful after he defeated Sephiroth. In fact, it was that was called the failure, not Cloud. But like I said, with all things failure, people that only see failure does not see hidden potential. So Prompto has hidden potential. Being part MT, he can sense demons. He would also have some demon abilities that Ravis would have. Now, we don't know because this episode is going to be recorded before episode Prompto. But if you request a part 2, just let me know in the comments or let me know on Twitter. I'll be happy. Now, let's get started in the battle. Now, when it comes to speed, they'd both be regular. They'd both be at the same... It'd be a draw at the speed because they're both just regular humans. Now, Prompto could be a little bit faster on the fact he's part MT. So, Prompto wins in terms of speed. And magic usage, I'd have to say Laguna, because Laguna matches the draw system, and pretty much the only magic that Prompto actually uses is ones that come from his gun, such as the bright thing. And that won't affect Laguna, since Laguna is a human and not a demon. So, that wouldn't work. Pretty much. Even if he did the aim thing. And when it comes to like gun abilities, they're both at the same kind of level. Except Laguna's at least a little bit masterful, just a little bit, because he was part of the Galbadian Imperial Army and he was one of the best out there. Pretty much if I can compare Laguna to any comic book character, he's like Batman's Deadshot, you know, pretty much. Sharpshooter. So when it comes to gun abilities, I'd say Laguna would win this one. When it comes to physical attacks, I think it'd be a draw because they don't really focus on physical attributes or physical feats, so they'd be a draw right there. When it comes to tactician smarts, I have to give it to Laguna on the fact that he's been in battle, and sometimes Prompto could be a little bit of a klutz, thus slowing the party down. So I'd have to give it to Laguna right there. As well. Now Prompto has fought enemies before, but only with the group. Now, we don't know how the fight with Verstale is going to be, and we don't know Verstale's true power, so we're going to have to leave that out of this death battle discussion, because, well, we have no idea. So, even though he's fought the likes of Ravis, even Idolus, but it was with the bros, I'd have to say Laguna would probably win this death battle because Laguna's fought something even stronger than what Prompto is. Laguna actually defeated Sorceress Adele and sealed her up in the moon. And if you didn't know, Sorceress Adele is immortal. Sorceress Adele is embodiment of all darkness and evil within the Final Fantasy VIII lore. And Laguna Lore was a regular soldier. Laguna Lore, with his comrades, was able to take out Sorceress Adele and fly her straight to the moon. Even though it didn't defeat her, it floated her straight to the moon and stopped her attacks for a long time until Ultimecia's intermission. And, well, I messed that up. But nonetheless, I'd have to say Laguna would win on the fact that he's fought people that are like Prompto or... You know, people that are like, well, I'd say as straight as MTs. Because if you go through Laguna Lore's adventures, you fight all powerful monsters. Really, really powerful monsters. So, you know, you fight a whole bunch of, you know, monsters you never know you were going to fight. So, and even then, he sealed Sorceress Adele up to the moon and sealed her away. Even though it was a complete defeat because Squall was the one who took out Sorceress Adele, you know, it's still, for a normal human that's kind of like Prompto, and, you know, and he don't have, like, the tactician personality to take out a powerhouse, an immortal powerhouse sorceress like Adele and send her to the moon, that's one powerful dude. That's just one, you know, that's just one powerful dude. That's one dude that... You kind of don't want to mess with. I gotta say that. You wouldn't want to mess with. And not only that, but even in Dissidia verse, Laguna Lore was able to stand up to the likes of Sephiroth, X-Death, and other Final Fantasy villains with powerhouses. So I'm sorry to say this to, like, Prompto fans, but Prompto is very strong. Prompto would give Laguna Lore a run for his money. Especially if Prompto was to... If Prompto were to unlock his hidden MT abilities, like his full MT abilities, and pretty much trained like Ravis did, he pretty much could probably win this one. He probably would have a fair shot against Laguna Lore. But Laguna Lore has fought Final Fantasy villains from other worlds in Dissidia, and he's fought someone that was an immortal powerhouse known as Sorceress Adele. And the Sorceress in Final Fantasy are pretty much like just like the power of a first-class soldier in Final Fantasy VII. The Sorceress are like one of the strongest classes and races in the Final Fantasy VIII lore. Pretty much, if you could compare Sorceress Adele's strength, Sorceress Adele's strength is that of Crisis Core Sephiroth, pretty much. Except she's immortal, kind of. A little bit, kind of. Kind of have partial immortality because she dabbled in the dark arts even further than Ultimecia has. That's why she looks the way she does. But you could go back and look at my Sorceress Adele was human at one point. But nonetheless, Laguna Lore would win due to the fact he's faced stronger opponents than what Prompto has faced. And Prompto has not unlocked his true MT power. Now, if you unlocked his true MT power and trained the same way Ravis did, then he probably would beat Laguna Lore. So, there's a little bit of fairness right there. So, Laguna Lore will win this death battle. Tell me what you think. Like and subscribe, share, do all that great stuff, and may the crystal be with you.
Can't keep my dick in my pants, ayy. My bitch don't love me no more, ayy. She kicked me out on life, bro.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Yeah. Ayy. Yeah. Ayy. Yeah. Ayy. Yeah.